Hello everyone, we will study section 2, antimicrobial resistance, intrinsic, acquired, and adaptive. Antibiotic resistance is inhibited by bacteria, can be intrinsic, acquired, or adaptive. 1. Intrinsic resistance is defined as the resistance inhibited due to the inherent property of the bacterium. Example of intrinsic resistance include the glycopeptide transistance inhibited by gram-negative bacteria due to the impermeability of the autoantibody present in the gram-negative bacteria cell envelope. 2. Acquired resistance is defined as the resistance inhibited when a previously sensitive bacterium acquire a resistance mechanism by either mutation or acquire a new genetic material from a exogenous source. Horizontal gene transfer can occur through the three main mechanisms. Transformation is a form of genetic recombination in which 3D fragments from a dead bacteria enter recipient bacteria and are incorporated into its chromosome. Only few bacteria are naturally transformable. Transduction involves the transfer of genetic material between a donor and recipient bacterium by bacterial phage. Conjunction. This is probably the most important mechanism of horizontal gene transfer. It involves the transfer of genetic material from one bacterial cell to another by directly physical contact between the cells. A six pillars form between the two bacterial cells, through which plasmid is transferred from the donor cell to the recipient cell. Multiple resistant genes are often present on a single plasmid, enabling the transfer of multiple resistance in a single conjunction event. The symbol of multiple resistance genes on a single plasmid is emitted by mobile genetic elements. 3. Adaptive resistance. It defines the resistance to one or more antibiotics induced by a specific environmental signal. In contrast to the intrinsic and acquired resistance, adaptive resistance will allow bacteria to respond more rapidly to antibiotic challenge, generally revert to the original state once the inducing signal is removed. Adaptive resistance seems to be the result of modulations in gene expression as opposed to environmental change, rather than being caused by genetic alteration, which usually produce irreversible phenotype. Adaptive resistance is probably the result of epigenetic change. Demethylation by demethylase could be responsible for the presence of a different gene expression profile in a bacteria population and could prove the heterogenetic and epigenetic heterogeneity of gene expression essential for adaptive resistance to occur. In particular, modulation of the expression of efflux pumps and porins have been implicated in the emergence of adaptive resistance. The phenomenon of adaptive resistance may be responsible for the difference observed when comparing the in vitro and in vivo effectiveness of antibiotic and could be involved in the clinical failure of antibiotic treatment. Moreover, the increase in resistance in response to environmental stimuli may not complete revert upon removal of the stimuli, leading to a gradual decrease in MIC over time. Finally, it has been proposed that the ability of the bacterial population to proliferate in the presence of a sub-inhibitory level of antibiotics through adaptive resistance may eventually allow for more effective and permanent mechanism of resistance to develop. This class is over. Thank you.